As the Atlantic Ocean is churned up by the passing of Hurricane Larry, the waves that crash ashore, as well as the sand dunes just out of their reach, along North Carolina's Outer Banks, are being closely looked at by multiple entities.
The beauty of this experiment and of what the U.S. Coastal Research Program is trying to do is bring together federal agencies, academic institutions, and stakeholders.
The team of scientists and engineers are operating in multiple spots along the Outer Banks, working to get a clearer understanding of how storms impact shorelines.
The DUNEX is really focused on understanding all of the processes occurring at the coast during extreme storms and how they interplay with each other and compound with each other to create hazards for our coastal communities.
It's addressing user-inspired research, which means the stakeholders know they need to understand sediment transport. They know they need to understand why the dunes are washing over onto the highways, right? And then this research will eventually come back, it will close the circle, and it will inform those municipalities and users of science about how to better manage coastal systems for increased resilience.
Scientists have deployed multiple sensors and other equipment in both upland locations and in the surf zone at the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers Field Research Facility in Duck, North Carolina, a facility that is no stranger to coastal studies.
The FRF is a coastal observatory and research facility that's part of ERDC. It's been here since 1977, and it was originally developed to help us better understand how the environment responds to coastal storms.
The scientists say that thanks to previous experiments performed at the research facility, there is a good understanding of what takes place in both the surf zone and upland along the dune line. However, they admit there are gaps they are working to fill through the DUNEX research and how the two interact with one another during a storm.
We have a really pretty good understanding about the hydrodynamics, right? We understand kind of how waves come in and how they change and then how they impact our beaches, but we don't know things like how storm waves affect beaches and then how after the storm the beaches recover.
Being experts in different processes that impact the coast, we can bring that expertise together to have a more complete, comprehensive understanding of what the storm's going to do, how it's going to impact our coastlines.
Ultimately, the researchers say the science will assist local, state, and federal entities determine how to best manage beach and shorelines, as well as provide local communities with knowledge on how to best plan for storm impacts.
DUNEX is going to provide some really foundational data sets during extreme storms that are going to allow us to evaluate and develop better models for predicting how our coasts respond during extreme storms. And that's going to enable us to design better beach nourishments that are more resilient to these coastal storms. It'll help us understand where we should put sand dunes, how high should we build those sand dunes, what type of vegetation should we put on the sand dune.
Data collection is expected to run through the remainder of the 2021 Atlantic Ocean hurricane season and into the early part of the basin's nor'easter season. Scientists and engineers will begin pulling apart the data in the months and years to come. From Duck, North Carolina, Patrick Bloodgood.